to introduce our speaker. And our speaker, he graduated from the Department of Electronic and Electronic Engineering and Information Science in USTC for the first degree. He working at a visiting scholar at the University of Waterloo in Canada, and then he graduated PhD from Key Lab of Quantum Information, University of Science and Technology of China in Hefei. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our speaker, Dr. Yibo Sao.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's my great pleasure to make a lecture in Thailand on the topic quantum cryptography. Maybe many of you are engineers rather than physicists, so my topic should be, this topic much easier to engineer. So let's begin. First, let us think a problem, a question. What will happen if we encode a signal or information on quantum state? Traditionally, we just encode our information on some classical things, for example, the voltage or the intensity of the light, such encoding. But what will happen if we encode the information on the quantum state? For example, if we encode a zero or one to a polarization or a phase state of a photon, what will happen? Yeah, that's very essential. We know that the phenomenon of a photon is quite different with from a phenomenon of this big project, right? So the quantum information may be very different from the classical information. The quantum mechanism bring us to a new world, and also can bring our information sense to a new field. We call that quantum information, okay? What quantum information can bring to us? Okay, that's quantum computer and quantum cryptography. Up to now, we know these two big progress. Yeah, that's quantum information can bring to us. Okay. For example, what difference between quantum information and classical information? In quantum information, we call a bit as a quantum bit. A quantum bit can denote 0 or 1. Just as the classical information, we denote the 0 and 1 through voltage or intensity. But if we denote the signal by a quantum state, what will happen? We know that a quantum state is not sure, not certain. That's the uncertain zero. That means it may be zero or maybe one at the same time. Yeah, that's a very essential problem. So, why classical bit can only denote one signal? Why classical memory can only store one signal at the same time? But why quantum memory can store 0 and 1 at the same time? Right? It's quite different between quantum and classic. Also, we know that everything in classic can be copied, right? We can copy the paper by some printer. But it's quantum, we may not do that. That's different. So in classic, we can observe every part, every object very precisely, right? But in quantum, we may not. So a classical bit can be copied, but a quantum one may not. The quantum bit may be unique, you know, might be unique, only one. So it's a big difference between quantum bit and classical bit. So it's a quantum mechanism bring to us a new phenomenon. So all of the quantum cryptography and the quantum computer actually are based on such phenomena. Okay. Now let us take a look at the famous quantum cryptography protocol, that BBS4. Here I just give you an example. Actually, the procedure of the BBS4 is very complex. I cannot tell you in few minutes. Let you know in few minutes. I just give you some logic thing. So, in this protocol, Alice, a sender, sender. We call a sender as Alice, and we call the receiver as Bob. And ever drop as Eve. Okay, there are three people: Alice, Bob, and Eve. Okay. Alice modulate a signal, zero or one, on a single photon, and send this single photon to Bob. One photon denote one signal, okay, zero or one, and send this photon to Bob, okay, and we know that one photon cannot be split into two photons, right? It's the minimum thing. So one photon cannot be split into two photons. So this is the one phenomenon. Okay, another phenomenon. One photon cannot be copied. That's unique. That's the second thing. Okay, the third thing is that one cannot observe a photon exactly. I mean that if this is a photon, I cannot observe it at first and make a same way at the same time. I cannot do that. If I observe this photon, I just break it. So a photon cannot be observed exactly. There are three phenomena. Okay, if they are the eavesdropper, who want to stolen the information? Store the information. Okay. First kind of the method. He might, in classical method, in classical field, he might split the beam of the light by some things. For example, Alice sent a light to Bob, and Eve get information, get split some beam light by some beam splitter, and he get the information. But at here, Alice only sent one photo to Bob. They are the only one. Eve cannot split a one photo into two. So if Eve receives a photo, then Bob cannot receive it, right? It is only one. If Bob received a photo, and Eve cannot get that photo, it's only one photo. Okay. Also, Eve cannot copy this photo and give that photo to Bob, and he hold another one. He cannot, because the photon cannot be copied. Okay. And also, Eve cannot observe this photon at first and get the information and make another one and send it to Bob. He cannot do it, because the quantum state cannot be observed exactly. So the photon Alice sent to Bob. If Bob receives that, then it's unique. They are the only one. So, if the photon Alice sent to Bob, received by Bob, it cannot be received by Eve at the same time. If a photon received by Eve, it cannot be received by Bob at the same time. Okay. Finally, if Bob tells Alice which photon he received and which photon he had not received, then Alice and Bob give up all the photons that Bob have not received. Finally, they only keep few photons that Bob received. That means, for example, Alice sent Bob 1,000 photons and only 10 photons Bob received. Then Alice and Bob only took these 10 photos, only 10 photos, and get the information, zero or one information from this photo. And then they hold 10-digit numbers. These 10-digit numbers can be called secret keys. Finally, Alice and Bob hold 10 secret keys, right? Okay, use these 10 secret keys, they can do anything for the information security. Yeah. So this is a basic principle of the BBS4 protocol. Okay. It's a simple explanation, but not exact one. We should explain it as by some mathematical things, but it's very complex. Okay. Now I just tell you about the principle, basic principle of the quantum cryptography. Okay, what can it be used? We know in classical information security, we should have secret keys, symmetric secret keys, to do some information security, to realize some usage. For example, encryption, authentication, and many other usage. I mean, in classical security, information security, secret keys is very essential. Okay. In classical field, we just transmit the secret keys by ISI, such as some algorithm, like ISI algorithm. We just transmit the secret keys by some algorithm. Here, we can transmit the secret keys through quantum key distribution system. And if Alice and Bob get a quantum keys, private keys, I mean symmetric keys, through quantum key distribution, and Alice and Bob can use these keys to do some classical encryption or decryption, right? So the secret keys, symmetric secret keys, is essential to the traditional information security. So QKD just provide secret keys to security. Yeah, that's its usage. Okay, up to now there are many scams for the QKD, for the quantum key distribution, including decoy BBS4, continuous variable QKD, and differential phase shift QKD, and many others. Okay. But up to now, most of us just use this one because the security proof of the BBS4 is sufficient. But the security proof for this one and this one are still under some performance. Yeah. So mainly we use this one. And for the BBS4 protocol, I mean for the decoy BBS4 protocol, there are also many realized methods. For example, we can modulate the information through the phase encoding and polarization encoding. And for the phase coding, we have two scans. One is FM, that means the Faraday maker interferometers. And another, we can direct code it on phase of our photon. So there are many realizations for BBS4. There are so many protocols, but how can we prove the security of it in mathematics? I mean, we should prove the security of such protocols exactly, not in principle. So there are some description. It's a quantum description. Okay, I just give you a sense and quickly skip it. We know that in quantum mechanism, we can describe everything by quantum state. We can describe this way, everything, or both, even though I can be described by our quantum state. So these are basic things, that we describe everything, include the secret keys, by quantum state. This Alice, this Bob, and this Eve. I have a dropper hold a quantum state like this one. Bob hold a quantum state like this one, and Alice hold a quantum state like this one. Okay. Through the quantum key distribution, at least the quantum state and the bulk of quantum state have some relationship, maybe entangled. And if get some information that we call another rule, it means everything at least bulk hold, include the exact one or some digital things, can be described by a quantum state. The security actually means the state Alice and Bob finally hold. If they do some measurement, a measurement actually in quantum mechanism, we can describe the measurement by some quantum operation. That means a quantum state, rho I, after a measurement, becomes a state. Y state is x. This x might be a classical data. This classical data can also be described by a quantum state. So everything are quantum. So after measurement, Alice and Bob finally hold a single case, also can be described by a quantum state. That means, what is security? Security actually means Alice and Bob's state finally are the same. So they have symmetric single case. Alice and Bob's quantum state are the same. And if the quantum state have no relationship with Alice and Bob's state, so it's secure. It's secure. Okay, this is a basic method to prove the security of quantum key distribution. In mathematics, we can do some do the security proof and such procedure. Finally, we can prove the security. There are several security proof methods, including entanglement distillation, information zero, Bell inequality, and such methods. There are several methods to prove any scheme of quantum key distribution. So these are security proof one. Okay, many of you are engineers, so I will not give any detailed method about security proof, so just skip it. So this is the proof procedure, security proof procedure, we just skip it. Okay. In a real system, what procedure should we do? Okay. If Alice and Bob want to establish a quantum key distribution system and finally get some secret keys, there are two key points. One is the quantum channel. That's to transmit a quantum state from Alice to Bob. And another is a classical channel. Classical channel is to transmit some information between Alice and Bob. So a classical channel, this one is also very essential to quantum key distribution. This classical, we require that a classical channel should be authentic, unconditionally secure. It's a very high requirement. So, to realize such a classical channel, we should, Alice and Bob should have some secret keys before the transmission. We call that initial case. Initial secret keys. So before the transmission, Alice and Bob should share a series of keys at first. What is used to do? Yeah, it's used to do authentication. He is maybe far away from me. I cannot see him. And during our communication, I should authenticate him by initial case. And also, at later, we do some quantum and classical communications. After the classical communications, we should do the authentication later. After authentication, then we can distill the final secret keys. And use the final secret keys, we can provide more secret keys to do the authentication for the next communications. So, the quantum key distribution is also based on the classical theory. We should share a classical six keys at first, and then do quantum communication. Then do some authentication and get the secret keys finally, and do the authentication in the next communication. Okay, this is the quantum this is a procedure of a quantum mechanism, quantum key distribution. Okay, how should we realize this authentication? Okay, if the authentication is not unconditionally secure, all the procedure is not secure, right? The key point is the authentication. Actually, in the information security field, we know that Winter Cotton, a Hashi function. If we use a Hashi function, means Winter Cotton Hashi function, and we at the two point have the symmetric secret keys, they can realize unconditionally secure authentication. We know that. But we should change the secret keys after Y communication. That means Y secret keys can only be used for Ys. Then we can realize the information security. So this authentication is actually very important to the quantum distribution. Yeah. This is a procedure of the quantum key distribution. Okay. I have showed you about the showed you a scenario about the quantum key distribution. What is the advantage? Okay, first one. It's unconditionally secure. It's the security of QKD can be proved. We know in classical field the security of algorithm cannot be proved exactly. But in quantum field, we can prove it. The security, we know the security, whether it's secure or not. Yeah, we can prove it. This is the first advantage. The second advantage of the quantum distribution is that Alice and Bob can share long enough symmetric secret keys through QKD. Long enough. If you want one billion, or 10 billion, so much secret keys, doesn't matter. We can transmit through quantum channel. Yeah, we can realize it. So if we have long enough symmetric secret keys, we can do much things, much more things than classical one. So this is a second advantage. And the third advantage is that the secret keys Alice and Bob share, I mean, if there are long secret keys series, each bit are uncorrelated. If we lose some of the secret keys, we can use the remainder one. That means the secret key series is uncorrelated with each other. Okay. And the fourth one is that if Alice and Bob don't have enough keys, they can refresh it at any time through quantum channel. So it's very easy to distribute the secret keys between Alice and Bob. So it's an advantage of quantum keys, QKD. It's quite different from the classical one, yeah. Okay. The quantum key, yeah, what is the usage? How can we use it? Where we should use it? Okay. We know the information security is very essential for a country. For a person, the security might not be very essential, but for a country, it's very essential, right? We know that in US, they just set up a network army. Yeah. Also, in England, there are also a network army, about 6,000 people. Also, in Japan, there are also a network army, about 5,000 people. What they do? Yeah. they get information from every outside country. Yeah. Maybe some information in Thailand actually are gotten by them. Do you believe? Okay. There's evident in America, in US. One guy called Snowden, now is in Russia. He just tell the world almost everything in many other country actually are not secure. Even the call of a president of a country can be known by US government. Yeah. Maybe some governor in Thailand. Yeah. They are, if they do some telephone call or do some transmit, do send something, some information through internet. Yeah. The US Army, England Army, or Japanese Army can know your information. So the information security is actually very serious in every country. Okay, the next thing they do is to break the network. If there are some urgent things, they can break down all of your internet things. Yeah, that's the second thing they can do. Normally, they do not do it. But do you know a war in Iraq? Yeah, do you know a war in Iraq? American army just break down the network in Iraq. So they just load everything. They cannot fight against US Army because they are non-network. So it's very serious. So the information security is essential to our country. Very, very, very essential. I think in Thailand, every country, governors should put a lot of money on the security. Yeah. Actually, up to now, there are many loopholes in the classical network and classical computers. Every time, yeah, we may often get attacked by some others. If we found a loophole, and we can get information from a loophole, previously in 2001, it might take 6 months for me to get some information from a loophole. And in 2005, it might cost me only two days. And up now, it might cost me only 2 hours to get some information from some loopholes. And another thing is that quantum computer, maybe you know, it's very powerful. The quantum computer is very powerful. It proved that a quantum computer can thoroughly break the RSA algorithm. That means if there is a computer, quantum computer, the classical security, some classical algorithm might not be secure anyway. So if there is a quantum computer, some of our encryption method or some information might be lost. Yeah, I mean, this one, it's very powerful. So, the quantum key distribution might be very important. I mean, maybe, yeah. So there is a challenge to QKD. Why I call it challenge? Okay. The classical security is guaranteed by algorithm, right? And if there's a quantum computer, for example, ISI, a famous algorithm, can be broken. Yeah, can be broken. But unfortunately, we have another method guaranteed by quantum information. We call that quantum key distribution. Yeah? Okay, the quantum mechanism brings us two new things. One is quantum computer, another one is quantum key distribution. A quantum computer can break the classical security algorithm. But quantum key distribution cannot be broken by a quantum computer. Yeah. quantum mechanism give us a swap and also give another one. Yeah. So it's a challenge. They are the challenge to quantum QKD. Actually, in Chinese government, they know that the QKD should be used all over the country before the appearance of the quantum computer. That means the quantum computer can be realized within 10 years. Maybe, yeah. Many have said that the quantum computer can be realized in 10 years. So the quantum key distribution should be used within 10 years. So it's urgent. Yeah. Okay, this is a challenge to quantum key distribution. Now, what is the progress in many countries? Okay. In US, we know that this is a DARPA network. Okay. It realized in 2005. There are some reports about the US progress, about the progress in the US. Maybe they keep it in secret. Yeah. Also in Europe, we know there is a network. We call that SEC OQC. Yeah. Realized in 28. Yeah, this is another network in Europe. It's a fine node. Also in Japan, in 2010, there also a network in Tokyo. Okay, this is some progress in some other country. And this is the progress in China. Okay, we have three generations of the quantum QKD equipment. This is the first generation of us. Looks dark, okay. This is the second generation. Okay, the picture is not clear. Actually, it seems that. And this is the third generation. Yeah, in our laboratory. It looks good, right? Yeah, this is the third generation. Yeah. Okay. To realize such equipment, we have also do some field test. The first field test is the quantum line. We established a quantum line between Beijing and Tianjin in 2004. Yeah, this is also a first real field test in the world. We just use this structure. We call this FM fast encoding method. Through this method, we can get a very stable quantum data transmission. That means, okay, this fiber is a commercial one, a commercial fiber. We rent the fiber from a telecom company. Yeah, and we just sent a quantum QKD center at here, at a QKD receiver at here, and transmit the quantum keys through this channel. This is the reality in 2004. And later in 2007, we just realized a full node network in Beijing. Yeah, this is the structure of the network. This is the second network in the world. Also use this scheme, and we route the signal through the wavelength router, like this one. Yeah, this is the second network in the world. Finally, in 1929, we just set up a quantum network in Wuhu and use it for the government. That means the government transmits the information through this network. That is the first usage in the world. It's about 7 nodes. Yeah. Maybe you can find some report on the internet. This is the first usage of the quantum QKD. During this test, we found that we just transmit some classical information, some paper or some voice web signal and some video signal through the channel. it transmit the transmission is okay. It can be used real in real in real field. Yeah, we can see. Later in 2000 and in 2011, we realized that 2 GHz modulation a system with 2 GHz modulation and transmit a signal along 260 km through a fiber about 260 km. Yeah. This is the longest transmission in the world in 2011. Yeah, that is the longest transmission. In this system, we just realize the modulation through a fast modulation. We just do a fast modulation and receive the signal through a superconductor detector. So this is a very, very high speed and a very, very long distance. Okay, this is another of our system realized in 2011. Okay, this is the progress of our technique in our laboratory, in our university. Okay, with such so many technologies, what we should do? What can we do? Yeah, that to found a company, start a company. Yeah, we start a company named FAQSK Quantum Technology Company. This is the fourth company operating on quantum techniques. Okay. It founded at our university. Our university just put the technology to this company, and another company just put money in this one. We just found this company in 29 July. Yeah. We found our company in July 29. And how much money we got? About 50 million yuan. We got so much money. So we established our company. Okay. The product. What product of our company? Why is this one? Okay. This is a quantum key distribution system. Actually, this system is developed in our laboratory before, and we just put the technology to our company, and then we get this equipment. In this equipment, we just realize the QKD through the decoy BB84 protocol, and the modulation of this system is about 20 megahertz. And what is the advantage? Okay, it's free from the vibration of the fiber. That means if a quantum channel is established between two parties, and if there's some vibration in the middle of the fiber, it doesn't matter. Yeah. So this system can be used at everywhere. This is one of our product. Another of our product is a quantum key distribution system. This one is realized by the modulation of this system is realized by a polarization modulation. So we the frequency of the modulation is about 50 megahertz. Yeah, this is another product of our company. And the coding is polarization coding. Also use BB84 protocol. The secret key rate can reach to YKBS. Yeah. And at 25 kilometers, about tunation about 5 dB. The QBER, that means QBER, not the final, not the BER of the secret keys, I mean the QBER. Less than 3.5%. Yeah, this is another product. Besides the quantum QKD system, we also produce another product. For example, the router. This is used to transmit signal between many users. Okay, it just do the router for a network. Yeah, this is a router, quantum router. Another product is quantum weeping. Yeah, most of you, I think most of you just know what is weeping. Yeah, in classical field, it is realized by some algorithm. But here, we realize the same. Yeah, the same function through quantum keys. In traditional weeping, we just transmit the symmetric secret keys through ISI algorithm. After Alice and Bob get the symmetric keys, they just do the encryption and decryption through DES or AES algorithm. Here we just transmit the secret keys through QKD and do the encryption and decryption through AES or DES algorithm. So we just instead of the traditional ISI algorithm by the QKD one, yeah, we just do such things. So this is another product we use. Actually, in that field test, I mean in that network in Wuhu, we just use this one to transmit classical information. For example, video signal and wave signal like others. So this is another product we produce. Okay. This is a single photon detector. We know that in a quantum QKD system, a single photon detector is essential. Alice sent one single photon. Send a single photon to Bob, and Bob received the photon by this one. So we also produce this one. Yeah, this is another product in our company. Okay.
May I interrupt? Briefly turn to a few pages before. For polarization QKD.
Okay.
Yes, is this machine it for free space quantum channel?
No, not free space.
For fiber?
In fiber, yeah.
Now, how polarized photon is properly propagated in fiber?
How many?
Because normally in fiber is good for only for phase modulation and for like amplitude modulation, but what about polarization? This machine, how does it work?
The modulation is about 50 megahertz, right? And we use this decoy step BBS4 protocol. It's about 0.6 photon, mean photon, in one wave pulse.
It is similar to the ID quantic product.
That product in ID quantic is realized by phase modulation, not polarization modulation. We just realized by polarization modulation. Yeah. And maybe there are some change during the transmission, right? We correct the change, correct the errors every minute. Yeah. Maybe there are some change during the channel. We just correct the errors every minute. Yeah.
So that is not a pure polarization, polarized photon.
Yeah.
Okay. Continue.
Yeah. Okay. Maybe you can see our paper. Several months later. Yeah. About this system. Okay. Okay. This scenario of the usage. In this fiber, in this layer, we call this layer, we transmit quantum keys through a traditional fiber. This layer we call the quantum key layer. In quantum key layer, we transmit secret keys, symmetric secret keys. Okay, this is the usage usage layer. Actually, it's our internet layer. In this layer, we use some, for example, we might transmit the telecom information, video information, or other information. Yeah, we just protect the information through some product, like the VPN or other encryption equipment. So in this layer, we divide the whole layer into two. Okay, this is the traditional layer. We do not want to change anything about the traditional internet. We just want to set up another layer to provide the security of our traditional internet. So we should not do any change about our current internet. We just set up another layer to protect the information security. Yeah. So we divide the whole layer into two. This is the traditional one. This is the quantum one. Yeah. Okay, this is the use case. Later, we have realized, established a real network between Hefei and Wuhu. This is the longest transmission at that in the world. Okay. In Hefei, this point is actually in our university, in our laboratory. And through the telecom, through the fiber of the telecom, we transmit the signal to Chaohu at first. Chaohu is a city between Hefei and Wuhu. And then we transmit the quantum information to Wuhu again. Okay. Actually, this one is a trust repeater. It receives the quantum information at first, and then read it, and later send another quantum information to this one. Actually, this is a receiver at the center, at the transistor. This is a transistor. This is a receiver at the transistor. This is a receiver. So we establish 3 points to transmit the information between Hefei and Wuhu. And this is a scenario in Hefei and Wuhu. This is a scenario in Wuhu. I actually use the product of our company. You can see that. It's just what I have showed before. We use this product to transmit signal from Hefei to Wuhu. Yeah. And this is the structure of the light. And actually, we have two lasers. One laser is to produce the quantum signal, and another laser is to make a synchronization. I mean, make the time between two parties, keep the time same, to do the synchronization. And then we transmit the signal through the fiber to the QKD receiver. And this is the structure of our QKD. Just do the FM modulation, phase modulation. This is the network. Okay, top structure. We transmit the information from Hefei to Chaohu from Chaohu to our company. Actually, we just connect our company with our laboratory. This is the top structure. This is also some structures. Okay. Finally, we realize the result. The length of the fiber between Hefei and Chaohu is about 85.1 kilometers. The attenuation between Wuhu and Hefei and Chaohu is about 18 dB. Yeah. Okay, the secret key red is about what? Okay, this is wrong. Okay, this is the. Okay, this one is wrong. Okay, we keep the QBR below 2%. is very low. I mean, the QBR between Alice and Bob is below 2.2%. It's very low, actually. This is some result of our QKD network. We can see our result in this paper. We have published our paper. Okay, on this website, we can search our paper. Quantum internet could keep the safe from spying IRs. We can find our paper and find the report in some internet. Yeah, you can search it. That is a field test between Hefei and Wuhu. And we also have another test. Maybe if you know QKD, if you know quantum stat, you might know that a quantum stat might be easily broken by some channel vibration, you know. In classical field, we just encrypt the protect the information through many encoding methods because there might be something wrong in the channel. Also in the quantum channel, a quantum state might be easily changed. There might be many quantum errors during the transmission, especially if there is some vibration among the fiber. A quantum state transmitted through this fiber many errors can be caused by its vibration. Okay, actually, if we use this structure, I mean this structure, phase modulation, FM phase modulation, it's robust against the vibration. This is a field test over the fiber. Do you know this fiber? If there is some electricity transmission, some fiber may put along the electric line. You know, it means if there is some wind, the vibration of the fiber. This is the fiber, not the electric line. This is the fiber. The vibration is very heavy. So through our method, we can transmit our signal. Very good. It seems no influence by the vibration. So this is our one advantage, our product, stability. This is another of our field test. Currently, Chinese government just put a lot of money in this field. I know you, maybe you know some news from the internet. A most famous one is a quantum line between Beijing and Shanghai. This is the most famous project in China, and later maybe a quantum satellite will be sent. So, somebody told me that Chinese government is the richest in the world and puts most of our money into this field, into the quantum information. Yeah. So we are lucky. So we can. There are a lot of things for us to do. Yeah. So we are lucky. Okay. This is another project. You might see the result in the end of this year. Okay. This is my talk. Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you.